Hi there, fellow friends and thinkers. Welcome to another Stellaris Dev Diary number 94, a text and talk, ascension perks and surveying in Cherry. Now, what is it about? Surveying is gonna change, so exchanging star shards will no longer be possible, and ascension perks, some of them will be free. Let's get into more details. So, ascension perks, they were added in Utopia, as they say. Component to the tradition system. Now they've introduced some new unique ascension perks for machine empires, for example, and also for some hive mind things. So, these specifics, ascension perks for machine empires, and basically ascension perks, including habitats, will still require Utopia and Machine and Synthetic Dawn. And the other ascension perks, like the one for research, or the one for border range, or mastery of nature, like the terraforming perks, they will be free for everyone with a base game. So you get a taste of it, and you can do some things. Still powerful things, but you cannot ascend. So ascension is paid. And the rest of the ascension perks, apart from the ascension paths, so to say, is free now. Then surveying, communications, trading. As you can see here, you can trade communications now. And that will cost you quite a lot, but you will get communications with other empires then. So the question is, will that be an influence source anymore? Might not be. Might be. There's going to be more changes around that. So that's the first thing. The second thing is the way surveying, anomaly generation and star chart trading works has never really worked very well. It's what they say, okay. It's very unclear to players, you cannot discover anomalies in other empires' space. Well, you can. You can, I think, but it's just very, very unlikely because it has been surveyed over and over again by the other empire. So, So the question is, do they really understand the way they themselves do it? So it's a clear up. It's a clear up thing. It's counterintuitive that you would be punished for star chart trading and following that, of course, they've decided to remove that. As well as the ability to buy star charts from curators, replace it with the option to trade communications. Now, if you trade communications with an empire similar to empires like in Civilization, you will get their territory shown. So, the Terra Incognita changes. There's where that thing begins. So that's pretty big changes, and I really wanted more surveying, not less. I mean, I'm a big fan of surveying. Like the full process of exploring is for me highly exciting, but I feel it doesn't pay much except for the traditions that give you tons of research for it. So I think it should be more exciting even. There should be more to explore. But so they wanted to mention changes to Terra Incognita. So it must work properly with the bypasses. Now it gets into the wormholes and gateways. So you can unlock some of these things if you unlock a wormhole and then get there, just get there. So if you have visited a system, it is completely seen. Visited either means that you have been to a system with a ship or that the system is inside the borders of an empire that you have communications with. So they assume that your diplomat travels the whole empire. So such terrain cognita no longer needs to be manually lifted on empires you have met in order to not make them appear grey and washed out on the map, also making it easier to see important galactic features such as nebulas. And of course, not only nebulas, but all of their stations would be seen then. So it's much easier for, if you're playing militarist, to see which of the systems are important and which are not. Adding to that, that is the star bases that are coming. So if you see the star bases when you have communications with them, you know even better which systems are so important and which are not. So you probably also see the planets and what is on them. Formerly you've only seen like which is the capital and which is not the capital and the rough size of the planets, but now you, it seems you know everything, which is, from a tactical standpoint, I mean, it's making the player on par with the AI. And so it removes some parts of exploration from the game. So there's still exploration. And I have an urge to say, please put in deeper exploration. If you're taking away such a big exploration, which is, don't get me wrong, which is probably necessary to clear up, because, yeah, this is, of course, the star chart trading was such a thing. Like, you, if you were experienced, you would say, no, 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 and all the empires spammed you with it that liked you, so... Yeah, so it's good that this is cleared up, but I don't like I don't like it that there's a lot of chances for exploring removed from you, and we'll have to see how that is compensated within the traditions, because of course, if that is not changed, the traditions are not changed again. Like that exploring thing, giving you the research bonuses, then this tradition will be significantly weaker. Because, don't get me wrong, while I'm playing at the moment a Rogue Servitor game very far into the galaxy on a huge map. So, we're sending out 4 research ships and they're continually auto-exploring the galaxy and they're still not finished. And this is, I think, nearly 200 years into the game. So, that is something that will not be possible anymore. Like, it will be useless in late game, while now it is very useful in late game, because, like, we have, I think, 1,000 from every research. And of course, if you get a percentage of that from surveying a planet, like, that is absolutely crazy. I mean, we often get like 2,000 to 3,000, or at least 2,000 research we get per month, with a storage like per society per and so on. So. We don't get the 3,000. We get around 6,000 instead of 3,000, just because of this tradition. So it's very powerful late game, and in that case, it won't be anymore. You can also see here how the new borders work, and how do they work? They have some odd borders here where nothing is in it, but still, like, there is also nothing, so you have a hole in your empire. And then you can see that it is just based on who has which planet. So it is as stated, it is entirely not like something like border pressure is completely removed. And you always have to build something in a system to occupy it, which is logical. So that is something I like very much, because it was part of the advantage of very big empires that you could press on the borders like forever, taking away tons of systems of smaller empires with a bunch of frontier outposts. That was one of my favorite methods, like building a bunch of frontier outposts and then taking away 2, 3, 4 still colonizable planets of other empires. It was a fascinating part to leverage, to invest influence in catching that, but it was probably not realistic in a way. And I mean, why would there be borders that work that strictly if there's no one inhabited there? And I would go so far as to remove possession of a system altogether. Why would there be possession of a system? There are, like, you could have just someone settling on a planet, and there's another planet, and there will be another one, another guy settling there. It could lead to severe diplomatic consequences, but why could you block, or how could you block the colonization there? You would have to attack the colony ship. This is the way this would be done, is maybe the next step. Maybe this is just the preparation for that, maybe it's not. So it's still a map-based system, when space in reality has no real maps, just there's a lot of nothing, right? And how would you control such a big bunch of nothingness? Except with force and flying there and removing the intruders. So I'd be happy to hear your thoughts on this dev diary. It was a small one, but still very interesting, I think. And sorry if I ranted. it just got me thinking. These small changes sometimes got me thinking. I'm not overwhelmed by the amount of changes, and then it gets me thinking. And what I really like about it is the ability to trade communications. That really values exploration empires, because then you have the chance, like, to send out your science ships and maybe for your communications that you give away, get a research agreement or something like that. So you get that research that way. That said, thank you for watching. And happy gaming to you. I'm gonna test some U4 now. I cannot resist. And I'm still gonna place some Stellaris probably. So have a good time until then. And happy gaming if you like this. And there's further news, of course, coming of the dev diaries that are coming. And there's a lot of dev diaries I've already covered that are there. I've linked them on my blog, on my website too. In like the complete Cherry Age post. I've linked it in the cards and in the end screen, so you can access it easily. There's links to all the original posts from Paradox, and there's links to all the videos, and there's short summaries of what is in the dev diaries. So happy gaming to you, and have a good time until next time.